Cornette have been talking about it during the entire Power Hour. The wrestlers are standing by. The ring announcer is ready, and we are about to go to this week's main event.
Well, I got a little taste of Arn Anderson's outlook on this match when he took his thumb and drew a line across his neck from ear to ear. Arn Anderson's not going to come out here and curtsy and bow. Arn Anderson, there's nothing nice about him, and he's not going to exchange any pleasantries. He's going to do whatever he has to do, however he has to do it. That's what I admire about Arn Anderson. What I don't admire about Arn Anderson is the way that he, just like Ric Flair, has been curtsying and kowtowing to these fans, these rednecks out here.
You mean treating them with respect?
Treating them with, hey, the people have asked me time after time to give the fans a little respect. So I give them as little respect as I can. They don't deserve any respect. Arn Anderson, Ric Flair, even Ole, they've been doing that. That's going to be their downfall.
Nice waistlock go behind by Arn Anderson. Waistlocking the great Muta, who goes to the ropes very quickly, which will necessitate a break. This match, if you just joined us here on the Power Hour, is for the World Television Championship. Arn Anderson is challenging the great Muta.
It's the first time that Arn Anderson has gone after a major championship since returning to the NWA. The World TV title.
Takedown, near fall. And the Oriental Man quickly grabbed the ropes and slid outside. That's smart wrestling on Muta's part.
Muta has picked up a lot of the dirty tricks of the trade, a lot of the shortcuts. In his time in the NWA, he's faced the top competition. He's here tonight, like we said, without former manager Gary Hart, who I understand, like I said, has had some serious problems with the JTEX Corporation. And after all, they own the contracts. They call the shots, and it appears that Mr. Hart may have some serious explaining to do, if he can explain recent events, like the Iron Man.
Well, he was the man responsible for the strategy for the great Muta in that contest that particular evening.
He blew it, didn't he?
Well,
let's just be honest.
Arn Anderson now being punished there by the great Muta, double wrist lock. Double A taken to his knees. No doubt Anderson has the advantage in the strength department in this match. Muta is a great tactician. I'm sure he will attempt to keep Anderson at bay, meaning off his feet as much as he can. But Anderson is a superb strategist. No one knows the squared circle any better than this man. He has learned so well. It's been a family tradition throughout the years, first with Gene and then with Ole, and now with Arn.
Well, Arn Anderson is a smart cookie, and he's a tough cookie. He doesn't have the big, massive physique. He's got conditioning, cardiovascular conditioning. Look at that move. He knows his way around. If he's upside down or right side up, he's still going to know the parts of the body to grab and where he is in the ring. That's what I admire about this guy as a wrestler. Wait a minute. Look who's coming to ringside. The Dragon Master and Buzz Sawyer.
Well, I guess Buzz Sawyer has been assigned by the JTEX Corporation to lead the team.
Trouble now, because it's 3-on-1, and like you said, Buzz Sawyer, he has the best command of the English language out of the three of them, so obviously he has been chosen interim leader of the group.
Makes a lot of sense. Sawyer's got experience in the Orient. He wrestles there periodically. As you said, he has somewhat mastered the English language.
Well, at least he's closer than the other two. Let's put it that way.
You're right in that respect. Break of the eye by the great Muta. Arn Anderson now in trouble as Muta tries to mount some offense. Neither man has been able to mount a sustained offensive
attack. Wow.
He missed a karate kick, but Anderson did not miss. Standing vertical suplex, and he muscled him up. Muta is in trouble.
Brother, I tell you what, if Muta had connected with that sweeping kick, then Arn Anderson's head would have been looking like a cabbage in the fifth row. But Anderson managed to duck it and came back with a suplex of his own.
Anderson leaning on it. The big, giant arm wrapped around the head of the great Muta. Muta trying to stay and remain on the vertical base to relieve some of the pressure. Anderson, I'm sure, will try to take him down. Oh, what a head.
Well, I agree with his sentiment. I wish these fans would shut up. But that cranium, brother, looks like a relief map of the Western Hemisphere. Speaking of faces, look at that one. Arn Anderson doesn't claim to be beautiful. The good thing he doesn't. Look at the Dragon Master. Boy, it's a shame. Oh, look at that thing.
Are there any nice-looking Oriental guys?
referee's the nicest looking guy in the ring, and he looks like he had his face put on fire or put out with an axe.
Well, I'll tell you something. In the NWA, it's not who can pose. It's not who has an animal with them. It's who is tough in their gut. And both these guys are so tough. Oh, what a move. What an adjustment. This is the NWA at its finest, man on man. Boy, he's sick. That Buzz Sawyer is sick.
Buzz Sawyer is a sick man. He's mentally ill. I love the guy. I love him. Muta, tremendous move. Power drive elbow. A minute ago, he caught Anderson with that super reverse thrust kick out of nowhere. Then he comes in with the power drive elbow, and now Muta's blinding speed is taking over, and Arn Anderson is having to gasp for air and wonder what's going on.
There's Dennis Sprint of the Wrestling Wrap-Up, the official publication of World Championship Wrestling. The new 1990 edition has got Steam on the cover.
I'm inside, too. There's a picture of me in the Wrestling Wrap-Up.
Yeah, suitable for darts.
Well, I understand you didn't make the centerfold either, big guy.
Muta's up on the top rope. It could be curtains for Anderson. The big judo chop off the top. And Arn Anderson is in deep, deep jeopardy here. The challenger for the television championship is in trouble. A gut check on the power out.
I tell you what, Muta has looked sharper, has looked better and more effective in this match than he has in 6 months. He has got renewed spark, and maybe this guy, Buzz Sawyer, is putting these ideas in his head, making him more vicious, more punishing. I don't know, just a thought.
Sawyer is borderline psychotic, and he may have Muta motivated to a frenzy. Apparently, that's what we have because Arn Anderson, who I deeply respect as one of the toughest men I have ever been around, is in a lot of trouble. There's no doubt he will not quit. He will not submit. And right here is a submission move. Well, Anderson got it out here. Muta's got it perfectly locked in, Corny.
Another one of those Japanese submission moves. Has both the arms underhooked. A beautiful back bridge. It's only gut that's preventing Arn Anderson from giving up right now. Look at the expression on his face. Brother, these guys are going for it.
The new horsemen, including Sting, Arn and Ole Anderson, and Ric Flair. They've had a great rivalry with J-Tex. Recently, Sawyer's minus two or three teeth thanks to Arn Anderson.
Oh,
he's fighting back. He fought right back up to his feet. What a man. He's all man, I'll tell you that. He missed with that big left, but Muta did not miss with that thrust kick. He caught Anderson right in the face, and Sawyer and the Dragon Master there to taunt the fallen challenger.
Well, I'll tell you what, right now, four horsemen or no four horsemen, Arn Anderson's looking in rough shape, and he's got three big, bad, ugly type of guys out there ready to see that he doesn't walk out of that ring with the World Television title. It would take Superman, Clark Kent, and Bruce Wayne all together to walk out with the belt with these three guys all around him.
You don't want to talk about Dick Grayson and Bruce Wayne anymore.
Oh, shut up. Hey, Sting ain't such a great choice for the fourth horseman either. I think he's too soft. Sting ain't going to live the horseman lifestyle. Sting is not going to want to go to the place and do the things that the horsemen do as part of daily activity. Sting wants to go take vitamins and talk to kids. I don't think he's going to fit in.
Oh, you're crazy. Of course he'll fit in.
He's going to fit in like a round peg in a square hole.
Well, we'll see. Time will tell. Arn Anderson has fought his way back up to his feet. I want to tell you something. He'll not be intimidated. He'll not be intimidated. If Dragon Master Sawyer got machetes and machine guns, he'll not be intimidated.
Hey, it don't look to me like they need machetes and machine guns. I'm saying with all three members of J-Tex out there, it would take King Kong and Godzilla to...
Anderson back in the corner now. He's in dire straits as Muta, the television champion, with his title on the line. Opens up with the inverted. Oh, he nailed it. An inverted atomic drop. That has just killed the spine of the great Muta.
Well, doggone it, you got to give him the credit for it. He keeps coming back. Every time it looks like Muta's ready to put him away, he comes charging back with some kind of move.
The second pile driver. Inverted atomic drop. trailing the mat.
Great Mark Anderson move. If he goes to slam him on the arm. Yes, he did it. That's a great Mark Anderson move. Did that send pain, send chills and shivers up your spine?
Not as bad as that dadgum inverted atomic drop, pal.
I didn't know that would do that. I always thought you were spineless.
Yeah, look in the mirror.
I do quite often. You're not happy with me anymore, are you, Jim?
I'm not happy with it because you lost $10,000 of your mama's hard-earned money.
Oh, hey, look, that's ancient history. Those dudes are going to be a mere stepping stone for us to win the World Tag Team title, Midnight Express in 1990. Now, let's get back to the match. Arn Anderson putting the pressure on Muta.
Abdominal stretch, he's got it locked in.
But Muta's working him over close to the ropes. Oh, wait a minute. The referee was trying to hold him. Muta did not throw Arn. They fell over.
Is that Bob Newhart? No, it's Bill After.
It's Bill After.
Anderson, on chest first into the steel railing. That surrounds the ring.
The point should be made. Muta did not throw Arn Anderson over the top rope. Muta was trying to get out of the hold. The ropes were too low. They fell over.
Thus far, Sawyer and the Dragon Master have not physically interfered. I don't have a lot of hope that that will last much longer. Oh, Anderson raked the eyes right across the laces. He'll break the rules. He'll bend the rules, and he'll break the bones.
He'll do it in a heartbeat.
There's a spine buster. The tide has turned. It's over. The Dragon Master's on the apron. Sawyer going up top.
Look at Buzz. He's coming off. Yeah.
Sawyer came off the top. The referee diverted by the Dragon Master. That should be a pin here for Muta.
This is it, brother. This is it. I told you. It would take Superman, Batman, King Kong, and Godzilla.
Oh, yes. Can you believe it?
No.
The crowd is stunned. He kicked out.
I can't believe it. I cannot believe Arn Anderson came up.
Oh, what
the? Muta can't believe it.
Muta has got to be a little bewildered. Oh, karate kick. That may finish Anderson off. That may finish him off. He may go now for the moonsault.
He's signaling for it. He's signaling for it. He's going to finish him off. Arn Anderson had his moment of glory. But in the end, the great Muta is going to show everybody he's going to be the world TV champion for a long time to come.
Here comes the move. Oh, his knees are up. Anderson pulled his knees up into the solar plexus of Muta.
What the heck is going on here?
DDT, what's going on? DDT, 1, 2, 3, yeah!
No!
Oh, ladies and gentlemen, here is your winner and new World Television Champion, Jimmy Arn Anderson!
The new Television Champion of the world, Arn Anderson!
I can't believe it, Jim Buzz Sawyer! He is beside himself! Buzz Sawyer's a madman! The great Muta is stunned! Dragon Master is bewildered! And Arn Anderson, he's the new champion!
Muta went for the moonsault, but then it was the knees up and the DDT. Oh. 1, 2, 3, a new champion. A new TV champion has been crowned. Don't go away. We'll be back on the Power Hour.
At least it happened on our show.